This mansion belonged to America's first president, George Washington. He called it home. Now visitors can see the humble abodes that housed Mount Vernon's many slaves just next door. After a 10-month restoration, the slave quarters have been reopened for the public. They are two wings that George Washington added on to the Mount Vernon greenhouse shortly after becoming president. They're divided into four large rooms, including one for men and another for women. Each room was heated by a fireplace. At the dedication ceremony, archaeologist Dennis Pogue said the restoration was the result of more than 20 years of research. He said the clothes, utensils, cups and glasses, brooms and baskets used by the slaves were also reproduced.
We have a lot. Archaeological materials that we've excavated from the slave quarter site. And from that, we know the kinds of things that they were actually, you know, using, the ceramics that they were eating from, and the food remains. I found lots of animal bones, so we know that they were eating lots and lots of wild animals, that they were, augmenting the rations that they were getting from the Washingtons.
These items bring to life the lifestyle of the craftsmen, cooks, servants, and farm laborers who were owned and worked on the Virginia estate for free.
We have some descriptions of what these quarters look like, and they describe them as huts, and they say that they're the most more miserable than, you know, than anything that you can imagine. And I think that, you know, we don't want to, you know, whitewash this part of the story. These folks were owned by other people. They had no rights of their own, and they were doing hard work.
Some of the reproduced items reflect how some slaves held on to their African heritage, like this ceramic bowl, a fabric doll, and a knitted cap. Several descendants of Washington slaves took part in the ceremony. They placed some of those items in the restored quarters. Among them was Ruhul Amin Quander, a senior administrative judge in Washington, D.C. He's a descendant of Suki Bey, a slave who lived at Mount Vernon and worked for George Washington.
For many years, their names are forgotten and the roles that they played were forgotten, yet the man they worked for, George Washington, glorified. We want to give these men and women their just due, because they are the ones who toiled from sunup to sundown 6 and 7 days a week, who made it possible for him to go off to do many, many great things that have benefited all of us.
How many people slept in one room in George Washington's house?
Oh, one.
One or two, right? How many slept in the slave quarters?
20.
Yes. Hey, good.
Beth Kayer, an elementary school teacher, brought her students to Mount Vernon as part of their history class.
Of course, some of the children have ancestors that came over that way, but it was a real eye-opener for them to see the contrast in lifestyles, and it's made a real impression on them.
Educating visitors about the harshness of slavery is one goal of the restoration. The point was not lost on Gloria Alice Holmes, another of Suki Bey's descendants who came to Mount Vernon for the dedication. She placed the ceramic bowl in the women's room.
It's raining today, and I'd like to say that, in my opinion, the rain, that's the tears of the slaves saying thank you for not forgetting us.
For writer Faiza El Masri, I'm Faith Lapidus, VOA News.